option. A strong showing of support from the Organization of American States would give us an umbrella of legitimacy.
A blockade is technically an act of war. Therefore, we recommend calling the action a quarantine.
Let's hope that translates into Russian the way we want it to.
There are between 20 and 30 Soviet ships underway to Cuba at this time. 800 miles out, the Navy would stop them, board, and any vessels containing weapons will be turned back. A quarantine prevents any more missiles from reaching Cuba, but it doesn't remove the missiles already there. It gives the Soviets a chance to pull back without a war. If they refuse to remove the missiles, we retain the option to strike and invade.
A sneak attack would be counter to what the United States stands for. It leaves us no room for maneuver, and the inevitable Soviet response would force us into a war.
Mr. President, there are still those of us who believe we should proceed with the strikes. Sir, with the blockade, we lose strategic surprise, and we also run the risks of the Soviets launching a first strike against us if they decide they have to use the missiles or lose them.
So quarantined or airstrike?
There is a third option. With either course, we undertake the risk of nuclear war. So it seems to me that maybe one of us in this room should be a coward. So I guess I'll be. A third course is to strike a deal. We trade Guantanamo and our missiles in Turkey, get them to pull their missiles out. We employ a back channel. We attribute the idea to Entente. Entente then raises it at the UN.
I don't think that's possible, Hadley. I've not yet made my final decision. I'll be asking the networks for airtime on Monday night. We'll announce our course of action then. Ted, I want you to get working on the speeches for both quarantine and airstrike. Well, thank you for all your advice, Jim.